today is the Budhavasara. This is the Shatvimshati Tamaha Dinankaha Asmin Asyamasasya. 26th of this month, it is Wednesday, and this is the Samasa Prakaranam, Dvanda Samasa Prakaranam. Sampratam Mangalasharam Kriyate Ramo Rajamanis Sada Vijayate Ramam Rameshaṁ Bhaje Ramena Vihata Nishachara Chamu Ramaya Tasmai Namaha Ramanasti Parayanam Parataram Ramasya Dasosmyaham Rame Chittale Sada Bhautame Bhora Mama Mudhara Rama Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Mano Rame Sahasanama Tattulyam Rama Nama Varanane श्री राम नाम वरानन ओं नम इति अथ श्री माहेश्वर सूत्राणि अ इ उण रल रक ए ओंग आई औच हय वरट वण ञ म ङ न नम जबं घड दश जब गड दश ख फ छ छ थ छ छ थ उ क पै श श सर हल इति माहेश्वर सूत्राणि. Okay, we are doing the homework last time we just started. Before we're in the homework, we are right now on this page number 122. And last time we did the first one, which is Pani Cha Padau Cha. We did this one last time, Pani Cha Padau Cha. Just want to go back, and as I was correcting the document, I noticed this one I left kind of incomplete last time when I did this. Diva plus Su plus, and we talked on, I just didn't finish the document, this part, this example. Diva plus Su, Div plus Su becomes the Div plus D plus Au plus Sa, that is the Diva Aut. First, I think I had a typo here last time. I put this as Div plus Au, should be just the Vakara takes the Aukara Adeshaha. So, look at 7184, Diva Aut, Diva Aut, Diva Aut, Diva Aut. As I said, this is confusing sutra because there are two sutras here, the Diva Aut and Diva Ut. Anyway, we went through this last time. I just, want to show the document was a little bit off. I had a couple of typos there. 7184, I'm sorry, 784, Diva Aut, Diva Aut, Diva Aut. So diva iti etasya au parata sau parataha au iti ayam adesha bhavati. So div iti pratipadikasya au syat sau alontyasya, of course, alontyasya. So the vakara takes the au adesha, and then of course eko yanachi, and then we get the prutta visargav. Okay, I should put this. Okay, then you have to use ikoyanachi. Ikoyanachi. So 6177 ikoyanachi, and then followed by the prutta visargav. So diva aut sau parataha gets the aut adeshaha. Actually, we also need to bring in the halantyam. Yeah, I forgot. Okay, halantyam. Okay. So upadesh arjuna nasika it, then halantyam for the out becoming au, alontyasya as usual, and then iko yernachi rutta visargau dyauhu. So that's second thing. The reason this is confusing is that there's another sutram called diva ut. Diva ut. That one is, that is when you have the padasanya. So diva ut is in Ashtadhyayi in a different place. Let me pull that up for you. Diva ut. Diva Ut and Diva Aut. Diva Ut, that's in 6.1, I think, Diva Ut we have. So Diva Ut, yeah. 6.1.131 is Diva Ut. So this is a different context. 6.1.131, Diva Ut, Diva Ut. So let's go to that for a second, 131. It says, Diva Anta Deshuka Padante. It's only Padante. It's when this Padante becomes Ukara, becomes Dubhyam, Dubhi, and all that. Anyway, so that we did this last time. I just want to correct the document for you. The other thing I left incomplete was in this Div plus Su plus Prithivi plus Su, Chartya Dvandvaha, then of course, Krutta Ditta Samasa, Supodhadi Padvitika Yoho, and divas prithivi, and then dyava prithivi, dyava prithivi. So that's because of this sutram which you saw is the 63, I think it's 30, 31, divasascha prithivyam, divasascha prithivyam. So you get divasadeshaha. So div takes divasadeshaha, and then because of the ch, it also gets the dyava adeshaha. So dyava, dyava, so dyava prithivi and divas prithivi. Of course, you require, when you decline it as divachanam, it becomes dyava prithivyau. Divas prithivyau, dyava prithivyau. Two things. And the other thing is that, in fact, if you bring our siddhanta comedy into play here now, so let's see what Bhattoji says on that sutram. As I mentioned to you last time, this Dvanda Samasa Prakaranam starts from 901 in Siddhanta Kaumudi. In fact, just like you got the hang of the Ashtadhyayi numbers, you can also maybe slowly start taking some idea of the Siddhanta Kaumudi numbers also. Of course, Ashtadhyayi numbers are top priority. Siddhanta Kaumudi, you can know some regions. So 901 starts the Dvanda Samasa Prakaranam. And then here is a sutram below where it says, Yesha, to go down here, divasascha prithivyam, diva ityeva chadyava. So it takes the divas and yava. Then adesha akara uccharanam, sakarasya rutvam mabhut. Ityatadartham. So the fact that Paniya made the Adesha Divasaha to show that Sakara should not be changed. Otherwise, if we just made Divas, Paniya could have had made the Sutram shorter, said Divascha. Divascha, but he made Divasascha. If he made it Divascha, there was no way for us to know that the Sakarasya Vikaro Mabhut, there should not be any change. But so divasascha Pani has made, Panini has made, so adeshe akar uccharanam. So the divasa adesha Pani made, divasa. So that ending akara is uccharanartham, which was put there to show that sakarasi ruttam mabhut. So should not do such a jisharu. This is what we did last time. Devascha prithivicha divas prithivyo dhyava prithivyo. Okay, so that's what I didn't complete last time properly. So divas prithivi, dhyava, prithivi, become divas, prithivyau, dhyava, prithivyau. And the Gita example also I didn't put last time properly here. It's number 1120 in Gita. Gita number 1120. 1120 in Gita, 1120. It will be here. Dhyava, prithivyau, radamancharanti, idamantaram hi vyaptan tvayikina nishashtya sarvaha. Dhyava, prithivyau, radamantaram hi. This is dhyava, prithivyau, prithivyoho, idamantaram hi. So this is, can be, you know, saptami, jivachanam, dhyava prithivyo ridamantaram hi, the space between earth and earth. Okay, so that was just from last time. Let's continue. Now, this homework is a tricky homework. This entire prakaranam is very tricky, very tricky. Of course, if you're not composing, if you're only reading, you don't have to worry about it because you already have the samasa in front of you. But if you are composing, then you have to be really careful and, you know, know these rules well. Let us start today. Let's see how far we can go. Please keep this entire thing, the Kaumudi. I think all of you should have this document. I think Kalpesh send you a copy. If you don't, let us know. We send you a copy of this. You should have a copy of this on your local computer also, so you don't have to watch the screen all the time. Please keep this in front of your eyes. Let's run through this one more time before we start the homework, okay? The trick here is that this entire, all these rules, starting from 242, 242 onwards, which tell us, you know, ekavat. So dvandvascha prani tulya senanganam, and it becomes ekavachanam. This entire prakaranam is niyamartham, niyamartham. Because any dvandva samasaha can, by chathe dvandvaha, there are two meanings allowed, which is the samahare and itaritara yoga. Itaritara yogaha. And in both of them are possible for any compound. So all this entire prakaranam, if this prakaranam were not there, 242 to 2416 were not there, then every dvandva samasa would go in either one, optionally. So that is that's our starting point. Our starting point is 2229 chathe dvandvaha. And then I think we also discussed a few classes back that there's even a paribhasha. I think where was that? Is that it was three or four classes back, that any dvandva samasaha can go in either one of them. So Paribhasha Sutram. Let me see. I think it was maybe 5-6 weeks back. It was in April, a month ago. Yes, sarvo dvandvaha vibhasha ekavat bhavati. Any dvandva samasa can take vibhasha ekavat. So that is our starting point from chartya dvandvaha. So all these examples that you're going to see, you have to go and start with this, that it can be vibhasha ekavat. Then after that, you come and see, can you, is it niyama being done? And the niyamas go back and forth. Some niyamas say samahara eva, some say, you know, itaratara yoga eva. We have to see how it goes. So that is very tricky. This really is one of the most tricky parts of our ashtadhyayi, I must say. This is, I mean, it looks very, you know, straightforward. But if you want to practice niyamartham, you come to this section. So let's do the best we can. Again, I am also not 100% sure of all these answers, but at least I can give you the way, and hopefully we'll not make any mistakes. So now the nyanyapakam for this was this 1263. Let's look at 1263 for briefly. So this is going to be a starting point from the homework. Vibhasha ekavat. Is that tishya punarvasvor nakshatra dvandve bahuvachanasya. That Panini puts this, you know, this thing about because Tushya and Punarvasu are two stars. So he says only when it's Bahuvachanam, then something should be done. Now why is Panini putting that? Because shouldn't it be Bahuvachanam all the time? Because there is, you know, Tushya is one nakshatra, and when Punarvasu are two of them. So it shouldn't be Bahuvachanam all the time, because there will be three of them. The fact that Panini is saying that only when it's Bahuvachanam, then do something, means that there is a possibility that it's not Bahuvachanam. So that is become one of the nyapakas for saying that this paribhasha, which is sarvo dvandvo vibhasha ekvad bhavati. Okay, so with that background, let's start the homework. Okay, let's go step. Firstly, thanks to Kalpesh. He's done some typing for us. We'll share some time in the class. So we have the document here. Okay, so let us see. Pani cha, this one we did last time. Pani cha padau cha. So in pani cha padau cha, what is happening is that we had this very first sutram, which is 242. In fact, let's just look at the Kaumudi itself. We can see the very first sutram here is dvandvascha prani turya senanganam and esham dvandvaha ekavatsyat panipadam. Says that mardangika panavikam ratikashvaroham. And then this is the important sentence here. It says samaharasya ekavatva deva ekatve siddhe niyamartham prakaranam. This is highlight this thing in your book, by the way. Niyamartham prakaranam. This entire prakaranam is niyamartham. Niyamartham. Then he says that pranyangadinam samaharaha eva yathasyat. Now just like you are doing the Parayanam of Bhagavad Gita, I hope all of you are doing. Please also do some Parayanam of the Siddhanta Kaumudi. Even if you don't understand anything, doesn't matter. Please do. This is really one of the greatest grammarians of our time. You know, she was really a Tavuda Vayyakarana. And what Siddhanta Kaumudi is for us, the authority. So please, if you have time, whatever time you have, we read one shloka Bhagavad Gita, one chapter of Gita. Try to read maybe four or five sutras from here. And extreme care and effort has been put into this text to make it very error-free and to also not include anything extra. So along with Gita, because Gita is top priority, but after that, you can start doing some Parayanam of this Siddhanta Kaumudi. So Dvandvat Prani Turya Senanganam Esham Dvandvaha Ekavatsyat. Of course, this document has some errors, but Pani Padam, we're going to work on correcting those. Mardangika Panavikam Ratikashvaroham Samaharasya Ekavatvade Ekatve Siddhe Niyamatam Prakaranam says Pranyangadinam Samahara Evasyat Yatha. So these can only take the Ekavat. So please read like this, Siddhanta Kaumudi, if you have time. So we did that last time. So Pani Chapado Cha Pani Au Pada Au Pani Pada the phone is Panipadas. This was the sutram 242. We said that you have to only make it ekavad, ekavad. So only supratya came in, and then of course we do the ato am amipurvaha. So we had in document last time. We had this whole thing. So pani au pada au. Of course, charte dvandvaha. There's only one sutra to begin with. Charte dvandvaha. The good news is there's only one single sutram in 212, charte dvandvaha. And then comes this one, the dvandvascha pranituriya senanganam. And this is ekavad eva syat. And then, of course, then we also talked about these three sutras are quite easy compared to the other section, which is the Puranipataha. So which one takes the Puranipataha, the Purapadam? Which one becomes Purapadam? And let's go there also for a second. And we have this dvandveghi ajajyadantam alpashtaram. Dvandveghi ajajyadantam alpashtaram. And alpashtaram has a number of vartikani on that, which we have gone through. So in this case, we have pani and pada. And what happened was that pani has the ghi sanya, dvandveghi, it went first. And we made it ekavat. And then, of course, did the supluk as usual. And then we did the sanapumsakam. This, when it becomes samahara, it becomes napumsakam. Of course, then suavjas, vadapratya su. And then we got atoam, amipurvaha. This is last time. Okay, now let's start. Okay, so we all going to work this together. And let's see how we can work this. So our starting point is chatya dvandvaha and vibhasha ekavat sarvatra. And after that, we're going to come to this section and see if we can nail down, you know, what is going on, if we can make some decisions. Okay, let us start. Now, next one in the book which we have is this one, which is the padatikascha dhanushkascha. So this is the foot soldiers and archers. Okay, so let's see what we can do. This is clearly a part of this same sutram, which says that the senangana, but there's one complication here. One complication. So we had to go to this vartikam down here. Vartikam. That's why this section is so complicated. It's so complicated. This is vartikam. Phala sena vanaspati mruga shakuni kshudra dantavaha kshudra jantu dhanya trunanam bahu prakritir eva dvandva ekavad iti vachyam. So for all of these items, in order to become ekavat, it has to be bahuvachanam, it has bahu prakriti. It should be referring to many, not one, not only, which we do have right now. But we have to keep this vartikam in mind on 2.4.12. This is probably the most complicated sutram. Vibhasha, vriksha, mruga, truna, dhanya, vyanjana, pashu, shakunya, shva, vadava, purvaparadharottaranam. And there's a vartikam, phala, sena, vanaspati, mruga, shakuni, kshudra jantu, dhanya, trinanam, bahu prakritir, eva dvandva, ekavaditi, vachyam. So right now we have to make sure that since we have sena here, we want to make sure it's bahu prakriti, which we do have. So we'll require this one, this 2.4.12 vartikam, along with the 2.4.2. And then finally we can, so let us do that. So I think, let's see what Kalpesha has typed in. So, okay. So we have padatikascha dhanushkascha. Laukika vigraha will be padatikascha dhanushkascha. And then esham samaharaha. Even in the prior one, which says, you know, pani cha padau cha esham samaharaha. So padatika dhanushkam. Let's take this whole thing and see if we can edit this one. This is Kalpesh has done this. Charte dvandvaha, then we do this one. Okay, let's start with this one. Okay, let's take this. This one is straightforward. We have, there's nothing, you know, atra samshaya nasti. There's no doubt over here. Sandeha nasti. So we can put it over here. And let's see. Okay. So padatikascha dhanushkascha, that's the example. And then we make a laukika vigraha, is that padatikascha dhanushkascha esham samaharaha. Okay, and we get the answer we give is the padatika dhanushkam. Okay, now how do we get that? Alaukika vigraha, padatika plus jas. So dhanushka plus chas, and we get padadika dhanushka. So here what we have done is that chartya dvandvaha, so I think we can put that here itself, chartya dvandvaha. That's our first sutram. If I don't need a sutra, we don't need this, we can take this out. So chartya dvandvaha 2 to 29, this is what we need to use right here to form the samasa itself, chartya dvandvaha. Now, how about the order of these things? How about the order? Because we got pa, da, ti, ka, and dha, nush, ka. So it looks to me, so we have to go back to our rules, which is in 2.4, which is, 2.2. So 2.2 we had alpashtaram. So alpashtaram, we have to watch out for alpashtaram. Because, here it is. Alpashtaram. So Kalpesha, are there? I don't even take alpashtaram into account because we had dvandve ghi. And so because here nobody has a ghi sanya. And then we have ajadya dantam, which also we don't have. Alpashtaram. We can do, but alpashtaram has the, of course, number of vartikani alpashtaram. Let's keep alpashtaram over here, which is 2 to 34. So even before we decide if it can be a samahare or itaritra yogaha, we have to see if we can, which one goes first in the compound. And there is the alpashtaram shabdarupam dvandve samase puram prayoktavyam lakshasanyagrodhascha plakshanyagrodhav, and so on examples are given. Vartikan Rutu Nakshatrana Manu Purvena, which doesn't affect us. And it says is that Hemant Lagvaksharam Puram Nipatati, that's one thing. And Abhyarhitam Chapuram Nipatati, that which is important goes first. Of course, this is, can always be invoked. And then it is, then some other things, Varanana Manu Purvena, and then Samanaksharanam Ityatra Nasti, and then Bratuscha Jaya Saha. So now this one is the, what we have is right now we have padatishpadatika, so padatika, it has four vowels, dhanushka, only three vowels. So I think alpashtaram, which probably I would tend to put this one first. If anyone has an objection, raise your hand, but I'm thinking of putting dhanushka first. Dhanushka padatikam is what I would say, unless you can somehow invoke the abhyarhitancha. I'm not seeing how this one. So Kalpesh, if you're there, if you have objection, let me know. But I'm thinking of putting this one first, this dhanushka plus jas, and then put padatika plus jas. Yes.
Kalpesh, so it might be my oversight, okay? I think I may not have looked into this aspect, so you may please correct it.
No, I know. I'm just saying, looks okay to you, this one?
Yeah, I think we have to do alpashtaram and then get padan, get the dhanushka first. You're doing right thing.
Okay, that's all. Okay, I just want to check with you. Okay, so dhanushka padatika seems to me, because, you know, the only other two rules that we have, which is the, again, this is more of an art form, not a science. So you have, these things are open to debate, okay? So the samasa is not like sandhi rules or like, you know, subandha prakaranam, mutinga prakaranam. This you will see, even though we're falling Panini rules, doesn't mean that the other form is like wrong, you know. You see, sometimes you will see violations. Anyway, so dvandve ghi, nothing is ghi. Yes.
Okay, Steve.
Yes.
You might have to take the line above also, you might have to correct that.
Yeah, I will do that. Sham Samaharaha. Yeah, so I guess we can put this one also first. So we had Dvandve Ghi.
It's not complete yet. There is a dash, padan.
In fact, that is the more important. Yes, you're right. This is the more important one. So Dhanushka, this is the more important one. In fact, the other one we could have kept as it is. So this one doesn't matter how you write this. This is fine, because you can even put this the other way. That won't affect, you know, that. This is just the this one. But when you put this one here, you put Dhanushka Padatikam, correct, yes, yes. And then, so anyway, Dvandve Ghi doesn't apply here. These don't have Ghi Sanya. Then Ajadyadantam also doesn't apply. There's nothing Ajadyadantam, is not there. Kalpashtaram, clearly Dhanushka should come. And the only way I can think Dhanushka being overruled is if somehow you can invoke the Abhyarhitam, which I'm thinking. And I don't know if there's any way to do that. So anyway, Abhyarhitam cha means something which is more important. This is outside the scope of Vyakaranam. So, you know, we don't know about that. But I mean, using the Vyakarana rule, it should be Dhanushka, Jas Padatika, Jas, and then make it Dhanushka Padatika. So now, here itself, we can also invoke this 242, which is saying the Senanganam 242, and also look at the Vartikam on 2412. It has to be Bhaprakriti, which is 2412, and that's the Vartikam on 2412. That gives the Dhanushka Padatika. So these two rules are to force only the Samaharaha. So it should be Senanganam is here, 242, and 2412 Vartikam is Bhaprakriti. So it has to be referring to many of them, which we do have. So then we can get, then of course, just a bit easy, Dhanushka Padatika plus Supratyaha, and then because it's going to be Ekavat, and of course, there's 412. I mean, rest of it is straightforward. And then after that, we apply, you know, the 247. These same rules before, same rules as this one. So 2412, and then, you know, all these rules to give this one. So, Sanapum Sakam, and then, you know, Ato Am, Amipurvaha. So those are all the same. Those are all the same. All the same. So, okay. Ato Am, Amipurvaha, to give the final form, Dhanushka Padatikam. Okay. So one more time is that this was forced to go only Samahare, because Senanganam, also Bhoprakriti was there, everything was satisfied, and Dhanushka went first because of the fact Alpashtaram. Okay, and then there was no Samasantakar there, I don't think so. Now let's see the next example. Now it gets more interesting. This was straightforward. Let's look at the next one. The next one in the book is the Ramascha Lakshmanascha. Okay, look at this one now. Of course, here Rama also has all good virtues, right? So, Sarve Sadgunaha Ramasya. He has Alpashtaram also, he also has the seniority in terms of age, in terms of other virtues. So, in every which way, Rama is going to go first. You can look at Alpashtaram, we can use that. We can also use there is the Vartikam, which we are looking before. And the Vartikam is the Bhratushcha Jayasaha Puru Nipato Vaktavyaha Vidishtarajanau. So the elder brother goes first. In fact, in this particular case, you can also invoke this one, Abhyarhitam Cha Purum Nipatati Iti Vaktavyam. So that one who's more important, so to speak, goes first. So on all three counts, Alpashtaram Sutram itself, the Vartikam, which is Bhratushcha Jayasaha, the elder brother, Purnipada Vaktavyaha, and Abhyarhitam Cha, one who has more importance. So on all three counts, Rama goes first. So 2 to 34. But now the question is about the Samaharaha or Itaritara Yogaha. I mean, as a starting point, I mentioned, you know, Sarvo Dvandvaha Vibhasha Ekavat. We should get either one. Now, can we force it to go only Samahara? Can we force it to go only Itaritara Yogaha? That's the question. So let's see what Kalpesh has typed over here. Whether if you want to raise your hand, let me get Anuji is quiet today. Let me see. Anuji, you have any opinion on this?
Oh, what? I thought it was iteratara dvandva. I thought.
But then how can you stop Samahara? That's the question I'm asking. So Kena Sutra Niyamaha, Niyama Kartum Shakyate.
Because it's not in that group, right? In that 2-4, 2-2.
Yeah, we have to be careful, Anuji, that this doesn't say that only which are here will take Samahara. It says that, you know, that it says, of course, these only will take Samahara, which are mentioned here. But every other Samahara is Vibhasha Ekavatya. It can take, in fact, just reading at the Nagesha's commentary on some of this, and he says there also that, says, let me read you this one line from Nageshaha. Is that, let me see if I can find it for you. But he clearly mentioned the fact that it is not in Yamaha that only which are here can take. He says, Samaharaha Pranyangadinam Eva Iti Niyamastu Na Vyakhyanat. Is that only these will take Samahara, nothing else will. Iti Na. That is not the Niyamaha. Niyamaha is not like that. It's only if it's mentioned here Samahara, others cannot take Samahara. That's not the Niyamaha. I should be honest with you, last time when we went with this lesson in the last round of Antoine, I think we got this wrong the last time around. The last time around, we are thinking what you are thinking, which is that unless it is mentioned here, it can only be Itaritara Yogaha. That is not correct. Well, let me tell you one more thing. Let's look at one more thing here. Patuji has given here an example on this Vibhasha. No, not that one. I'm sorry. He's given an example on this one. The Vipatishuddham Chanadhi Karanavati. And here he gives an example. If he goes on to explain some things, and he says, Vipratishuddham kim? Okay, so that Shitoshne, Shitoshnam, Sukadukkham, Sukadukhe. And then he says, Nandaka Panchajanyau. He gives, so Nandaka, I think, is the Sri Vishnu's sword, I think. Nandaka Panchajanyau. Here also, I think Nagesha gives a comment. Nandakaha is that Vishnoho Khadgam. And then the other one is the Harehe Khadgaha Nandakaha. So Nandakaha is Hari's sword. Shankascha Panchajanyaha. Oh, that comes in Gita, Panchajanyaha. That's his conch. Okay, that's fine. So Nandaka Panchajanya. But then look what he says after that. Iha Pakshikaha Samahardvandva Bhavatyeva. There will be a Pakshikaha Samahardvandvaha. So he says, Nandaka Panchajanya, this is the name of, this is the one name of, you know, the sword of Sri Hari, this is his conch. So fine, we got Nandaka Panchajanya, but then he says that, Iha Pakshikaha Samahara Dvandva Bhavatyeva, there will be a Samahara Dvandva. That's number one. Second thing is that, yeah, I'm sorry, this is a complicated prakaranam, I'm sorry, there's no other way to look at this, but we have to do the homework, right? This, look at this Ganaya, Na Dhadipaya Adivi. Is that they will not be, these will not go Samahara. Okay, the fact that Paniya, so these will not go Samahara means that they must, otherwise they would qualify for Samahara. Correct? The fact that Panini pushed some things in this Gana, which means that if they were not in this Gana, they would have taken Samahara otherwise. You know, Anyata Nishedasya, Prajanam Nasti Nishedasya, Prajanam Nasti. So let's look at this Gana for a second, this second clue. You know, so basically what we're trying to discuss here is that, is does this have to be only Tiritra Yoga? Can it go Samahara also? Let's look at 2.4.14. Score 2.4.14. Unfortunately, nobody clarifies this really in so much detail. That's the bad part. But, okay. 2.4.14 says, No Dadipaya Adini. This is not the right way to do this. This is wrong. It should be Dadipaya Adini. Dadipaya Adini. It should be like this. 2.4.14, there's a typo here. It should be 2.4.14, it should be like this. Na Dajipaya Adini. Okay, this is a Visarga Sandhi going on over here. Anyway, look at some of these things over here. It says, Brahma Prajapati. Brahma and Prajapati will only become Dvandva, only become the Itaritara Yogaha. Now the fact that Panini has to say that Brahma Prajapati will only become Itaritara Yogaha means compounds like this, other compounds like this can take both. Shiva Vaishravanau, like Shiva and Kubera, I think. Shiva Vaishravanau, again, is limited to only Itaritara Yogaha. But only these particular ones, not any others. Skanda Vishakhau, and so on, he gives some. So now, this is another indication that these were forced to be Itaritara Yogaha because in the Gana, in the Dadipaya Adini Ganaha. Okay, that's number one. Now, Rama Lakshmana is not there. Second thing is that, as I said here, that the example in Siddhanta Kaumari, Nandaka Panchajanyau, this is name of a sword and a conch. Iha Pakshikaha Samadvandva Bhavatyeva. Okay, let's run through this prakaranam one time, okay, Anuji, let's just read it one time. We have Rama Lakshmana is what we have. Ramash Lakshmanascha. Okay, is it Pranyanga? It is not. Suryanga, not Senanga, not. It's not part of an army or a band or, you know, of limbs. Okay. And these three we can skip. They're, you know, they don't have application here. They are, you know, very specific rules. Then Jatira Praninam. Is it a Jati? It's not a Jati. Rama is not a Jati. Jati means a genus. If there are many, many Ramas, that would be a Jati. But this is not a Jati. But this sutram doesn't apply. Jatira Praninam doesn't apply. And then because these are only two specific names of two particular people, not a Jati. Okay, then Vishishta Linganam, Nadi, Desha, Grama. This also, this is not a Nadi or Desha, doesn't apply. Next comes this Jantavaha, Dukshu Jantavaha, Kshudra Jantavaha. Kshudra Jantavaha, this case doesn't apply. This is called small insects and small animals. This one is the Yeshamcha Virodaha. There's no Virodha, Ramalakshmi, there's no Virodha at all. So that also doesn't come. Then we talk about Shudranam, that also doesn't come. Then Gavasha Prabhutini cha, I don't think Rama Lakshmana is in this Gana at all. You can take a look at it quickly, but it's not there. There's no Rama Lakshmana. Rama Lakshmana is not there. So if you look at that, there is no Rama Lakshmana over here. So that is gone. And then comes the Vivasha Vriksha. That's not. Mruga also no. Trina, Dhanya, Vyanjana, Pashu, Shakuni, Ashya Vadava, then Purva, Para, this is not there. There's nothing here. Then comes the this Vartikam which we saw, that also, I think it's the Vartikam over here, right? This Phala, Sena, Vanaspati, Mruga, Shakuni, nothing will go after Rama Lakshmana. And then the Vipatishiddham, that also is not there. Opposites, that's not there. Then Nadhipaya Adini, that's not there. So, and these two also don't apply. So we went through the whole Prakaranam. I don't see anything which is going to force Itaritara Yoga on this one. Looking at these examples, as I said, two examples. One thing is that here itself the Kaumudi gives Nandaka Panchajanyav Iha Pakshikaha Samahardvandu Bhavatyeva. So it becomes Nandaka Panchajanyam, Nandaka Panchajanyav, two forms. And as I said, the second thing we're looking at is that these compound which are in Dadipaya Adini, which have been forced to go through the yoga specifically. So we have the Brahma Prajapati, Kyo Vaishravanav. The fact that these have been forced to go there, which means that if they were not in this Gana, they should be taking both. Should be taking both. So my thinking is that I know the most common we see Rama Lakshmanav. Yes, yes.
The 2414. Kashika Vritti on 2414 seems to say that yatha yatham ekvad bhave prapte pratishedha arabhyate. That means that the prior sutra is bringing in ekvad, whatever may be, because maybe like dadi and paya might be opposite with each other or something like that.
So that's vyanjana.
Okay.
This one here, Kalpesh. Vyanjana.
Okay.
So that's coming here. Yeah. So but the prapti could also vikalpena prapti could be also, couldn't it be?
But what Kashika Vritti seems to indicate that it is, you know, that the ekvad bhava is prapta and this is giving you a pratishedha.
So then tell me then why what sutra we get ekvad bhava for Shyo Vaishnava now?
You're asking a question.
No, I'm saying that ekvad bhava prapta. Kena sutra prapta.
It has to be with one of the sutras gone by, right? No.
Well, I'm looking at them. I'm not seeing any, because if you look at the, that's what
because if it was always this thing, always there, then he would not have to mention a statement like this, right?
The thing is that it could be vikalpina prapta also. It could be vikalpina prapta. So that's what I'm saying, is that sarvo dvandvaha vivasha ekavat, right? So Shiva Vaishnavau could have been Shiva Vaishnavam also, maybe. But that we don't want that.
Okay.
Shiva Vaishnava only we want. So if you look at, you take Shiva and Vaishravana, I don't see anything here, because if you look at this whole Prakaranam, it is, you know, we just went, we'll look at it one more time. He says Prani Turiya Sena is not there. These next three are, don't apply. Then Jati, this is not Jati. Shiva is not Jati Vaishnava, this doesn't apply. Then Nadi Desha Gra, this also doesn't apply. Then the Jantavaha, you know, Kshudra Jantavaha doesn't apply. Then Virodha is also not there, you know. Then Shudranam not there. Gavasha Prabhudhini, it cannot be in both Ganas, doesn't make any sense. Then the vriksha mruga truna dhanya vyanjana is not in that list. That's also not there. Then vipati shuddham is not there. That's gone. Then dadipaya adini. So that's it. Because there's nothing here to put any gana.
Okay, yeah. That makes sense.
So my thinking is that this Shiva, in fact, if I look quickly in the Nyasapada Manjari, let's see if we can give anything. Now you mentioned that. Let's see. So 2.4.14, nadasipaya adini. Yeah, this is very complicated. It's not that straightforward. It's not very straightforward. And let's see if they give any clue. Dadipaya adini. Okay. Shiva Vaishrava now. Okay, let's see. Says, the dadipaya si iti adinam trayanam vyanjana vachinatvat vibhashayakavat bhava prapti. Okay. So first three is saying is that they are in the vyanjana. So they will get vibhasha. Dadipaya and then the, so dadipaya si sarpir madhuni. So this is dadhi means curds and, you know, payasam. This means sarp means ghee and honey. And madhu sarpishi. So this is both of them. The next one he says, let's see, nataka madhu sarpishi. Brahma prajapati. Ityadinam panchanam samahara ekavat. Ityadinam panchanam samahara ekavat praptihi. I think that's what he's saying in the Nyasa commentary, Kalpesh, is Brahma Prajapati Ityaji Trayana, Panchanam. From here, this Panchanam is what he's saying. So this is the five from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think this one, is Samahara Ekavat Prapti. So when they are Samahara, there will be Ekavat. I think that is this word. So it looks like it's supporting what we are saying. Okay, that's what he's saying. Brahma Prajapati Adishu Atra Patiteshu Samahara Dvandva Nisheda Mukhena Itaretara Yoga Dvandva Itaretara Yoga Dvandva Vyavasthapyate. So basically for these compounds, this Brahma Prajapati and Shiva Vaishnavana and Skanda Vishakhav, he says that Samahara Dvandva Nisheda Mukhena, by saying samahara cannot be done, saying that itaritara yoga dvandva vyavasthapyate. Vyavastha is being done. These can be only go in the itaritara yoga. So I think we are okay, Kalpesh. I think it looks like the vikalpa is praptaha. But from just chathya dvandva it comes. I think that, but these can only go in the itaritara yoga. That's what, because it says that samahara dvandva nisheda mukhena, by saying samahara cannot be done, itaritara yoga dvandva vyavasthapyate. Vyavastha means that some order is being made, that this can only go in itaritara yoga. So coming back to our example, which is the Ramascha Lakshmanascha. Straightforward example, Ramascha Lakshmanascha. So in this example that we have, this is not in any gana. So I think that this can go either way. It can go, of course Rama will go first, but in Ramascha Lakshmanascha it can go itaritara yoga, it will become Rama Lakshmanau, or become Ramascha Lakshmanascha Anayoho Samaharaha Rama Lakshmanam. This is what I'm thinking, Rama Lakshmanam. Of course, Rama Lakshmanam, you don't see Rama Lakshmanam most of the time. You see Rama Lakshmanau only you see. Lakshmanau only you see. But then the question, this is the trick in this Vyakaranam, you know, is you take your example and see how closely it fits to a example which is standard, to a standard example. So the example in Kaumudi which is standard now, authority for us is this one, which is the Nandaka Panchajanyam. Now, what is the difference between this one and Rama Lakshmano? Do we have a difference between these two? So Nandaka is a name of conch, of a sword. This is also a name of a conch. Now, if these can go into Samaharaha, why cannot Rama Lakshmano go into Samaharaha, is the question. And the second thing, as I said, is that this 2.4.14, the fact that, okay, Anuji has a good comment. Good, let's see what she has to say. Yes, Anuji.
Yes. Satyaji, those are also non-living. Rama, Lakshmana are living. That make a difference.
Okay, then you want to apraninam, right? Jatira apraninam. Because that's the only one says apraninam. So then you're talking about, I would think you're talking about this one, which is the...
No, if we compare Rama, Lakshmana to this example, the conch, right, you know, and the shankha, then that's non-living and Rama Lakshmana living.
Yes, true. But then we have to see which sutram will make the difference then. The one sutram which talks about apraninam is jatira praninam. Only about jati vachakas.
Right.
So it's true. Jati, if it was jati, I would buy argument. If it's jati, a prani naam. If it's prani or jati, you cannot do this samahara.
No, we can't.
I'm saying if.
But
if
can we take this non-living example? I don't know.
No, what I'm saying is that a prani naam only comes for jati. So, but okay.
No, I understand that.
No, but hold on.
But can we take that example and extrapolate it to Rama and Lakshman?
Well, you probably cannot, because then why do you have then Shiva Vaishnava in the Gana then? If you are right, okay, let's say you are right, they are living, okay. But then what's the point of proving Shiva Vaishnava now in the Dadipaya Adini Gana then?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, because then you don't need them to be here. Because if what you are saying is correct, then Shiva and Vaishnava and Shiva and Kubera. You don't need to put them in the Gana then.
Oh, okay.
I mean, that's what I'm saying, that the fact that they put Shiva Vaishnava in this Gana, which means that if they were not in the Gana, Samhara would have been Prapta, correct? It's obvious. Otherwise, you don't need to put it in the Gana. So, this is a clear indication to me that unless we are missing something, which I don't think we are, you know, that these can go in Samhara, you know, also, because we'll go through one more time. Let's take Shiva Vaishnava, okay? Like we said with Kalpesh, is that it's not Prani, you know, Surya Sena Angana, which is not there. These three are, next three are out. Then it's not a Jati. And it is not a Nadi Desha. It's not the Jantavaha. It's not Virodha Shashvatikaha. It's not Shudranam. Gavasha Prabhudini is not. Then, you know, Vriksha Mrigatrana Dhanya Venjana Pashu Shakunya. It's not in this list also. Then Vipatishuddham is not there. That's it. So I don't think there is a sutram which will make Shiva and Vaishnavana as a post to a Samahara. I think it's a Vibhasha coming from the Chachet Dvandvaha. You know, Vibhasha Ekavat Bhavati. Sarvo Dvandvaha Vibhasha Ekavat. So to stop that Vibhasha, I think Shiva Vaishnava put in this Gana, Dadipaya Adini. But then now compare our example, Rama Lakshmanau to Shiva Vaishnavanau, right? Let's compare those two now. This is not in this Gana. So then I think we can make this Samahara Dvandva. It's what I'm thinking. I know it sounds a bit strange. To make into Samahara from Ramanashwar sounds strange. But looking at this Root Sutras, I think we are okay with this one. So okay, anyway, think about it. I'll put it here in the document and we can still continue to think about it. See, this is not a, you know, like mathematics straightforward. And if you are not composing, you don't have to worry about it. You see Ramalakshman in front of your eyes, you don't have to think about it. But looking at the rules, it seems to me that, you know, we should be allowed to make into a Samahara Dvandva also. So, Ramashtya Lakshmanashtya, I mean, we won't put all the steps in detail. Of course, we have to use Alpashtaram, which is the, let's put in the document. So this is what I'm saying. This Prakaranam is like that. Prakaranam is like that, we have to accept it and, you know, do some thinking. I mean, it's interesting Prakaranam, but way too complicated. So this one is, Ramascha Lakshmanascha, Ramascha Lakshmanascha, Ramascha Lakshmanascha. And should become, so you use Charted, I mean, Rama Su, Lakshmana Su, we don't need to put all that anymore, right? We can do that, and of course, the usual rules, so Charted Dvandvaha is the main rule, and there's nothing to stop the Vibhasha here. I think. So we can get Rama Lakshmanau, Atva Rama, but what we do want to mention, of course, is the Alpashtaram, and the Bhratuhu Jayasaha, Purnipataha, and also want to mention the Abhyaritam. On all the counts, Rama goes first. So 2 to 34, Alpashtaram, will put that here. 2 to 34. I don't think we can force Itaritra Yoga on this. We'll make it Rama Lakshmanau. Rama Lakshmanau as well as Rama Lakshmanam is my thinking. Well, think about it, and if you feel next week that this is not correct, let me know. We will Rama Lakshmanam. Okay. Now comes the next one, Anuji. You want to try the next one for us? This is, next one might be easier. Next one is the, this one is easy. Aishchana Kulascha. the state four is already given the sutram here, which is the
249.
Yeah, virodha shashvatikaha. This is state four. So yesham virodha shashvatikaha. Yesham pragvatta. Samahara eva. Samahara eva. And that ahinakulam. This is Kamudi example, ahinakulam. And he says that there is no vibhasha also, because even the vibhasha, mruga, vriksha, mruga, iti praptam chakarena bhajyate. So this sutra, vibhasha, vriksha, mruga, and there is also a pashu over here. So these would take vibhasha, this is also parakaryam, but he says chakarena bhajyate. So vikalpa also is not there. So basically you use, and there's nothing special here. And so 249, so ahishcha nakulashcha. And of course here also we can look at our other rules, which is the ahi will get the dvandvegi. Also alpashtaram, and yeah, he'll get both of them. So nakula will go second, and the ahi will go first. So 2-2-32, 2-2-34. So I'll just put the final form here. I think that the Vigrahavakam is straightforward. It is ahi plus su plus nakula plus su. Usual steps. So we don't have to put there. So ahi nakulam. This was chathe dvandvaha. And then we can use 2-2-32. Dvandvegi. Alpashtaram. We, of course, yesham ch virodaha shashvatikaha. Ahi nakulam. Here it is, yesham ch virodaha shashvatikaha. Okay, now the...
Pratishti?
Yes, sir.
Coming back to the issue of Rama Lakshmana,
yes, sir.
Yeah, maybe the viruddha bhavam, if it is not there, how would you consider Rama and Ravana, Rama Ravana?
Yeah, Rava Ravana, that's an interesting one now. If you can know, that makes more of an interesting one. Because if you can the Virodaha Shashvatikaha. But you know, if you look at the examples here, Vasu, is that they give all the examples of, like, you know, snake and mongoose and, you know,
Rani,
yeah. I think the
The reason why I brought it up is in Bala Manorama when you are talking about Nandaka Panchajanya Aviti.
Yes.
There he's saying that Vipratishet Siddham Iti Uktautu Viruddhartanam Samaharaka Dvandashchete Tarhi Adhravya Vachinameva Iti Niyamo Labhyate. So I was wondering whether in the Rama Lakshmana, if there is no
viruddha bhava, is not there. Same thing in the Nandaka, you know, Panchajan. There is no viruddha bhava, so it's
viruddha
not
bhava. So you would what you are saying is,
but there's nothing to force the itaritra yoga, you know, or samahara.
Yeah, here he says iti kadachit samahara dvandaha kadachit itaritra yoga dvandaha bhavati eva. That's how he concludes that
there. Yes, so samahara dvandha bhavati eva. You can have samahara dvandha definitely. So, yes. So that example is crucial. So yeah, I don't see how we can force the itaritra yoga on Rama Lakshmana. But you know, we think about it. So okay. So let's see. So okay, I know you try next one for us. You know, next one for us is the swasacha bhrata cha. First of all, here always ladies first, feminine always goes first. Okay, so you can invoke it, and here of course we have to invoke that rule, which is the anang rutva dvandve. So anang rutva dvandve, we're going to do that. You know, vidya yoni sambandha vachina mrudanta nam dvandve anang syad. So hota potaro mata pitaro. We're going to make it, you know, swasa bhrataro. So, and of course, Sasu only has two ach, and both have two ach, but here we can use the, Sasu is Lagvaksharam, no? And the Bhratru has the Guru Aksharam. that should, that will make Sasru go first, and also Abhyarhitam. Ladies always go first in compounds. So all feminine names go first. Always Mata Pitarao, Radha Krishna Abhyan Namah, and so on. So now, but the question is that can we make the, what do you think here, Anuji? Can we make the Samahara? You have to make Itritra Yoga. What is your feeling over here? Prasacha Bhrata Cha. So first of all, we can get the, we can of course have the Vibhasha to Vibhasha Prapyate. And can we force this to go into either a Samahara or it has to go into the Itritra Yoga? Can we force one way or the other, or we cannot? That's what we have to think over here. Now, this is my thinking. Now, let's go back to Prakaranam. Again, the same thing. Okay, we have to go back and see if we can force one of these. The first one is straightforward, which is, says that the Prani Turiya Senanganam, no use, no this one. These three next, we can skip those three. That they don't apply in this case. Then comes the Jatira Praninam. How about this one now? Jatira Praninam. So, sister and brother. Sister and brother is, you know, there are many brothers, many sisters are possible. Unlike Rama Lakshmanau, this one now is a different thing. Because when you say Sastru and Bhratru, it's a generic term, sister, brother. It's not talking about a specific person. It's talking sister, brother. It should be a Praninam. So now we are stuck with, I think we can use this one, Jatira Praninam, because here it says that a Praninam, it says, Praninam to which Shudraha, is example Kashi, I mean Siddhanta Kaumudi gives. So I think here we can use the fact that Sastru and Bhratru are generic terms, the genus, you know, it's a jati. It's not one, like Rama Lakshmana is only one Rama, one Lakshmana. This is not a generic term. But sister, brother are generic terms. So my feeling is that we can invoke Jatira Praninam, and then he says, Praninam to Itrita Yoga Haiva, Praninam to Vichudraha, it only takes Tanda. So this is going to be reversed now. So this, by saying a Praninam, Panini is saying, then make a Niyamaha again. If it's a Jati Vachaka, if it's a generic term, and it's a living thing, which of course Sastru Bhatru are, then we cannot do the Samahara, we have to only go to the Itrita Yoga. So my thinking is that we can use 2, 4, 6 to force Itritra Yoga. It'll only be Swasa Bhratarau. It will not be Swasa Bhratru. Okay, so we can use this one. If you have any objection, raise your hand. But otherwise 2, 4, 6 should work over here. So first thing, let us start with So let us do the Sasacha. We can put the Alaukika Vigraha Vakyam, Sasasu plus Bhratru plus Su. Okay. And this is as usual the Chathe Dvandvaha. But here we are going to bring in the 2229. But now we're going to bring in the 2, 4 Jatira Praninam, which is 2, 4, 6. So make it only, so this is going to be Niyamaha. So Niyamaha is going to take, you know, the Itaretara Yogaha only will come here. Itaretara Yogaha. Yeah.
What is this? Matar Pitara Udicham.
Say it again. Where are you looking at?
Sutram 6332. Matar Pitara Udicham.
Yeah, this is some, that's only for Matra and Pitru, not for this one.
Okay.
So it says that Matra, this is Udicham, is a northern grammarian. Udicham is a northern grammarian. You can have it from Matra Pitarau. If you have Mata Pitarau, you can also have Matara Pitarau. According to the northern grammar, you can also have the form Matara Pitarau, is what he's saying. That's only for, you know, only for Matru and Pitru, not for this one. So look at 6332, so that will not come into play over here. 6332, if you look at that one. Specifically for that compound, and only ఉంది. సో మాతృపితరౌ ఇతి ఉదీచాం ఆచార్యాణాం మతేన అనంగ ఆదేశ మాతృశబ్దస్య నిపాత్యతే మాతర. సో అరంగాదేశ అరంగాదేశ బికమ్ మాతర. సో ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్ మాతర పితరౌ అకార్డింగ్ టు ది Northern grammarians and everything become Mata Pita. But it was only specific for those two, not for this one. So here I think this 2, 4, 6 Apraninam. Apraninam, because I mentioned Apraninam, I think here only we can only do Itratra Yogaha. Because this is a Jati Vachaka. Unlike the Rama Lakshmano, we could not do that. Itra Yogaha Eva. Then of course we're going to use the Alpashtaram 2 to 34 is going to come. And then we're going to use the Anangruto Dandve, which is Anangruto Dandve. So we're going to use this one because this is the Yoni Sambandha. So 6325 will be used, 6325 to get the. Of course, we'll get the Anangadeshaha. So Nitcha Sutram Nitcha will become the. Normally, a Anekaladeshaha will take Anekachis Sarvasya. Nitya is forced to go to the last one, become swasan, and then finally you will get the nalopa pralipadikantasya, nalopa pralipadikantasya. So we will have to, of course, remove the su, because kutrita samasascha, supodhadu pralipadikayoho, then do the anangadeshaha, then nitya sutram, and then also finally use the 8 to 7 to get the form. Swasa pitarau, swasa bhratarau, maybe you can decline it, you'll get, so swasa, and then bhratr is a pratipadikam, and then decline it dual, because itaritara yogaha, so you'll get swasa bhratarau, swasa, of course, the ruto nisrava namasthana yoho, swasa bhratarau, ruto nisrava namasthana yoho. Bhratarau, get guna adeshaha by I think it's 7, 3, 1, 1, 10 I think. Tutoni sarvanamasthana yoho. Decline dual. Tutoni sarvanamasthana yoho. So anyway, I mean that's really straightforward. But the step I think we have to watch out for here is the 2, 4, 6, which is jatira praninam. Jatira praninam, which is if you say jatihi, then it will be samaharaha only if it is a prani. If it's a prani and it's a jati, it will be only itratra yogaha. So I think sastra and bhratu will qualify for that. They are generic terms, not one specific person. They can refer to any sister, any brother. So I think we can use this one. Okay, let's see next one. Let's see, Anuji is back. Let me try her. Mutranuji, I think your mic is not working, I think. So.
No. Can you hear me now?
I can hear you. You have some background. It's okay. But Jaya, it's straightforward here. Same thing, right?
Yeah, same thing.
Because here also we have a jati. Wife and husband. So the same thing, which is that the, we can be, it's a generic term, it's a prani. And then, of course, you've seen this, you know, Jayapati, Jampati, Dampati. I think we already saw in a prior class, we saw Jayapati, Jampati, Dampati. So let's see, I'll just copy from there. Because this is in that Gana. You know, the Rajadanta Adishuparam. We saw Jayapati, Jampati, Dampati. Way back, I think it was in one of the old classes. Jayapati, Jampati, Dampati. So that this Jaya, which is the Jambhavaha and the Dambhavaha. Dambhavaha, Jambhavaha, Jayapati, Jayapati, Jayapati. And we had this before. Let me see. It was in one of the prior classes. Ratika Ashwaroha Ascha, Sarastri Vahacha. Okay, here it is. Jayapati, Jampati, Dampati. So Gana Sutram on 2 to 31. Which is the Rajadantadishuparam. So we had this Gana Sutram, which says that you can have the Jambhavaha and the Dambhavaha for the Jaya. look at 2231. Rajadantadishuparam, Rajadantadishuparam, Rajadantadishuparam. So it says, in the here it says that Jaya Pati Jampati Dampati Jaya Shabdasya Jambhavo Dambhavashcha Nipatyate. So it says the Ganasutraman 2231 says Jaya will take the Jam and the Dam, and Jaya will go also go first. Because normally Pati has the Lagvaksharam, Jaya is the Guru Aksharam, but she all goes first. So we use the Purnapataha and the Jambhavaha Dambhava optionally. So we have to put the 2229. Of course, you have this. There's no choice. You have to 2229 has to be used. No matter which way dvandva you do, any dvandva samasaha, you have to use chatya dvandva. Tatra samshaya nasti. Only one sutram. Because any samasaha has to start from one sutram in 2.1 or 2.2. There's no other way. There's no other way. You have to use sutram in 2.1, 2.2. And there's only one sutram in 2.2, chatya dvandva. So that has, you take that. And then you can use this kind of sutram to make the Jambhavaha, Dambhava, and also make the Purnapataha of the Jaya. Okay, that was we did already before. The next example is here, it talks about the Gruham cha Udhyanam cha. Okay, here's a good one. Here's a good one now. Gruham cha Udhyanam cha. What do we do with this one now? Of course, clearly the Gruham is going to be, let's look at which one will go first. Gruham or Udhyanam. Here we have two rules over here, one which is the Ajadyadantam, Ajadyadantam, so 2233, which Ajadyadantam, Ajadyadantam, and what do we have? Udhyanam, Udhyanam is Ajadi Adantam, but then we have Alpashtaram, comes later, it's a Parakaryam, Alpashtaram, so Gruham is his Alpashtaram, it has only two letters, while Udhyanam has three letters. Even though you have the Ajadyadantam, but Alpashtaram is going to say the one which has, it's a Parakaryam. It's a Parakaryam. So we have to go with that one that has more force. So we get Griha Udhyanam. But now coming back to our usual question, can we force a Samaharaha? Can we force into a Itaritara Yogaha? Let's see if we have anybody, any opinions on this one? What do you think, Anuji, over here? Any opinion? Gruham cha Udhyanam cha. What would it be? Can we take one or the other? Do we have to take one, have to take the other? What would it be?
They belong to different groups, right? Gruham cha Udhyanam.
How about Jatira Pranayam? Can we use that?
Yeah, that's the one I'm thinking. Yeah.
Yes, we can do that. If it's a house and a garden. So it can be generic terms. So there can be many houses, many gardens. It doesn't have to be, you know, one particular house. It just says house and garden. So house and garden is a generic term. It's not pointing to one specific house, you know, like White House or something. It's not pointing to one specific house. But, there's one it is, they say, is that dravya vishesha vivakshayam tu. If you're talking about one particular house and one particular garden in your mind, not general house garden, then you have to make it only the dvandva, the itritra yogaha. So one more time, jatira praninam, I think will work here, because gruham cha udhyanam cha. So gruham and udhyanam is generic terms, a house and a garden. So we could work that. But if you're talking about a specific house and a specific garden, then you cannot use the samaharaha. So if you're talking about just house, garden in general, Gruho Dhyanam, it's Samahara Dvandva, it is straightforward. If you're talking about one, yes.
Yeah. Here should be the answer for Rama Lakshmana, because it's a proper noun.
It's not Jati.
So that should be the justification for forcing Rama Lakshmana in the Itaretara Dvandva.
No, because it's only for Jati's thing, Vasu. This entire thing only for Jati, Vachaka. No, otherwise, no. So if there's no Jati, then you cannot come into Sutram at all.
We can't take Jati as the common noun versus proper noun.
So Rama is actually not a Jati.
It is not a common noun, it's a proper noun.
Proper noun.
Yeah. So in that sense, if we can take the generic sense of jati, it addresses the common nouns versus the proper noun like
a particular. No. What he is saying is that look at the example. Dravya vishesha vyavakshayam tu badaramalakani. So if you are talking about some specific berries and some specific, those are generic terms. Generic terms. If you're talking about specific ones, if only a few berries and few of these fruits, that you know something you have in your hand or in a pot, then you have to say badaramalakani. So then you are talking about these five berries or whatever and these three fruits. Dravya vishesha vivakshayam. Specific items in mind, which are generic items, but you want to refer to only these specific ones. Then you have to go into the Itritra Yoga. You can only say Badara Amalakam. We are talking about a general, you know, berry and general Amalakam. But if you are talking about, you know, the specific item which you have in front of you, then it is going to be, it's going to be Itritra. That's much only for Jati. It's only talking about Jati only. If there is no Jati, we are not coming here at all. Only for Jati the Praninam. So this Jati made a Niyamaha. By Jati Niyama was made in by Jati. And that said that you can only go in samahara, a praninam. For prani is going to be, you know, it has to go into itaritra yoga. But only for jati. This whole thing, niyama is only a sense of jati. So jati, if it is going to be a prani jati, it has to go itaritra yoga. A praninam is going to be samahara. But a praninam, only if it is not, this is samanya vivakshayam, not a vishesha vivakshayam, it will not be. So one more time, it's only about jati, and it is saying that if it's a prani jati, it has to go samahara. So prani jati has to go itaritra yoga. But even if it's a prani, if it is dravya vishesha vivakshayam, you come back to itaritra yoga. That is what the prakaranam is. And all this is only for jati. So Rama Lakshmana doesn't come here at all. It's not a jati at all to begin with. So you cannot come into sutram at all with jati. So I think this one, what we can say is that this Grahancha Udhyanancha, it will be Grahodhyanam if it is the Samanya Vivaksha. If it's going to be Dravya Vishesha Vivakshayam, become Grahodhyane. That's my thinking. Because this one, so you can bend this 2, 4, 6 both ways. So 2, 4, 6, I think we can. So let me just put this down here and we can think about it. So
this is.
Yes, what do you think?
Sridhi, in that jati, I think that as Vasuji is saying, probably that jati would mean that proper nouns or in this thing we cannot take it. Because if you see the example Kashyapa Vritti gives, he says jati tikim, okay, and there he gives, you know, Nandaka Panchajanyo, right?
Panchajanyo, right. So that Nandaka Panchajanyo doesn't come under the sutram at all.
Yeah, what it means is that it is a counter example for jati.
Yes, so it's not a jati.
Yeah, it is not a jati. So similarly, Rama and Lakshmana also is not a jati, right?
Not a jati. So you can go back to the, but Skalpesh, look at Skalpesh, but you know, it's a good example that you brought up. The Nandaka Panchajanya, right?
Yeah.
But look at this one, as I told in the beginning of the class, is that look at this one now, that this Kamudi has clearly said, Kamudi Bhattoji clearly says here, is that this one is, it says
Nandaka Panchajanyam
iha pakshikaha samahasanta bhavatyeva.
Agreed.
That's what I'm talking about. So yes, correct, this is not a jati. So it will not be subject of 2, 4, 6 at all.
Right.
Then you go back to the vivashayikavat sarvatra, you know.
So then these rules that are there, they are siddhya sati arambo niyamartha, is it? Is that what is happening?
Everything is niyamartha over here.
Yeah, so basically that means that what we get as a samahara dvandva here will be only samahara dvandva, but otherwise everything else can be samahara dvandva or itaritra dvandva.
Yes, so our base case is that vibhasha ekavat, it is going to be samahara or itaritra. Any dvandva as a starting point can go either way.
Okay.
And then we come here and start with niyama one way or the other. You know.
Right. So there's niyama if at all, whatever the niyama might bring in. So in this case, like jati, if at all we get a jati, then it will bring in a samahara only.
No, samahara only a praninam.
A praninam, yes, agreed.
So niyama both ways now.
Okay. That, oh, know, niyama both ways.
Yeah, both ways. If it's apraniya, it has to be samahara. If it's prani, it has to be tantra yoga only.
Okay.
Because see here it says prani nam tu which shudraha.
Okay.
So now that also is an interesting
thing. But it has to be not only prani nam, but it should be jati and prani nam.
Yeah, jati and prani, yes. Jati and
so
prani.
Jati, jati prani nam jati, yeah jati, then in that case we will do
other thing. That's what, so it, yes, it's very complicated, this thing. very complicated, it's extremely complicated. So anyway, coming back to our Rama Lakshmana, he's not a jati at all. So it's like basically like the Nandaka Panchajanya, like Rama Lakshmana.
Right.
So that one is clear. Now, Gruha and Udhyanam can be a jati now.
Yes,
so Gruha is a generic home, you know.
It is jati and not prani. So.
Not prani. But then comes this extra thing now. Dravya vivesha vishesha vivakshayam to it becomes, go back to samhara, the itaritra yoga then. If you're talking about one house and one garden that you have in mind, you cannot use samhara anymore. If you're talking about a specific house and specific garden, you have to make it itaritra yoga only. So it will be samhara, correct, but because of jati, aprani, it's correct, it will be samhara only. Unless you're talking about vishesha vivakshayam, will only be then Gruha Udhyane. So 2, 4, 6. So we'll put it like this. Let me take this down here. Okay. So let me take it like that. So 2, 4, 6. In fact, we can use Bhattoji's own words. So Gruhancha Udhyanancha Udhyanancha. What I'm thinking is that we can put it like this. Gruhancha Udhyanancha will be, of course, you know, when you know all the steps, you know, the Adguna and all that. We won't put all the steps in here. You normally should get the Gruhodhyanam by 2, 4. Jatira Praninam. But then the next step is that if you have the Dravya Vishesha Vivakshayam, if you have a specific house and a specific garden, then you have to make it Gruhodhyane. Gruhodhyane will become like that. So this is the complication here. I mean, it makes intuitive sense. You're talking about a general term of a house and garden in general. Then samahara comes into play. If you're talking about a house and a garden specific, then it's not a generic idea. So it is going to go into the Kitrata Yoga. So one more time, this Grahancha Udhyanancha. First of all, Gruham Alpashtaram. We had to put, well, I'll put this 2229 Chathedvandvaha, and also put the Alpashtaram over here, Alpashtaram. Then, of course, Jatira Praninam, it has to be Ekavat Samahara. But Dravya Vishesha Vivakshayam Tu Grahodhyane. This is my thinking about this. Okay, so think about this here, and next week you can think about all this, and you can always debate and ask, you know, if you feel something is incorrect. Now, next one is Apachya Vipachya. Apachya Vipachya. Again, let's go through our list. Let's start with, can this qualify for any Niyamaha? Can there be a Niyamaha for anything over here? So by this time, you should have some practice now, right? So let's go through this. Let's see if you can, this is, it's not Prani, Surya, Senanga, Nam, clearly doesn't come here. Then these next three don't apply. Jatira Prani Nam, how about that one? Is there anything coming over here? Shudravyavachi. So also with Dravya Vachi. So it has to be something which is a substance, not which is like a concept. So that will not, you know, so Rupa Rasau Gamana Kunchane. So I think this will not qualify for Jati. Jati has to be a Dravya Vachi. That is not coming. Then Nadi Desha, that's not Nadi Desha. Jantavaha is not there. Kshudjantavaha. Virodha Shashvatika, it's not Virodha. Apat Vyopi is the same thing. Apat and Vibhat. No Virodha over here. So no, there's no Virodha, so you cannot use that also. If you look at the meaning in Apte of Apad and Vipad, there will be no, so we look at Vipad. Vipad also Apad means difficulty. Both means that difficult times. Apad, Vipad. So I don't think we can invoke any of this Virodha. So Vipad, if you look at Vipad, Vipad and Apad, Vipad. Vipad means misfortune or bad state, And similarly, if you look at apad, also is going to be the same thing. Apatti. So apad is not, it's not an opposite meaning. So apad also will give similar meaning. Apatti, getting into trouble, into misfortune. So same thing. So we cannot use that either. We cannot use the viruddhartha anywhere. So that one is gone. Okay. Then shudranam doesn't help us. Gavasha Prabhudin, I don't think it's in this Gana. We can check, but 2411, I don't think it is there, 2411. By the way, some of these Ganas are Akriti Ganas, by the way. You have to be very careful. Particularly the Dadipayadin is Akriti Gana. See, sometimes if you see something which should have been a Samahara, it is not. Then you can invoke 2414, Dadipayadin, which is Akriti Gana. Akriti Gana. And Samahara is required and it's not being done. You can invoke 247, 2414, Akriti Gana, 2414, Akriti Gana. Anyway, I don't think this apad vipad is not here. I don't see apad vipad anywhere here. Even 2414, I don't think it is there. So even there also, I don't think it is there. No, it's not there. So now, what are we left with now? So this one, vriksha, mriga, truna, it's not in this list. And also not in this one, vipadishiddham is not there. Dadipayadin is not there. This is not there. Okay. So now, looks to me, I think we scanned everything. We had to go back to the, first of all, which one comes second? Apad, vipad. I think the vipad should come first because it is a lagvaksharam. Lagvaksharam purvam. Because if you have the, in fact, let's see, Kaumudi might also have that. Let's see, alpashtaram, lagvaksharam purvam, vartikam. So, kushakasham, abhyahitam. But I think we can use this one because apad, vipad. So vipad V is the lagvaksharam. Apad dirgha is always dirghascha, is always the guruaksharam. So I would think that I don't think we can use, there is nothing of the, because apad is ajadi, not adantam. So that also we cannot use. Dvandve ghi, there's no ghi sanyav here. And apad vipad have both two letters, but apad is guruaksharam, vipad is lagvaksharam. So I think we can use two. So we'll put vipad first. But now, between vipada apad, I think both should be okay. I'm not finding anything which will make it, So let me take from Kalpesh's notes here. Okay.
So Sadishji, between alpacharam and lagvaksharam, will there be a conflict? If so, which one will take precedence?
Alpacharam. Only if there's a conflict, then only comes lagvaksharam. Alpashtaram is dominating. That's the sutram. That goes. But only then otherwise, only when there's a conflict, only you take it. So look at the examples given over there, right? Look at the example that Bhattoji gives also. The example that he gives is kushakasham. It's also both are two and two. Then only you go to lagvaksharam. He didn't give the other one. So this is only two and two. So alpashtaram is, this is the most dominating. Alpashtaram is the most dominating sutram. Only when it fails, you have to go other places, So, okay. So my thinking is that if you take this apachya vipachya, I think we should get two forms. It should be vipadapad is my thinking, is what we should get. But I'm not seeing anything which is going to force one way or the other. So we go vipadapadam. So, okay, 36. Vipaccha, and of course the usual rules. So we are doing chatte dvandvaha, and then we are using the alpashtaram. So 2234 vartikam, and then we get vipadapadav when you use it in the itritra yogaha, or we get vipadapad, you can make it vipadapad. So that will be in the samahara. Seems to be okay to me because this is not, you cannot use jati because jati has to dravyavachi. It's not dravyavachi. And nothing is applied. This is not, virodha is not, vipatisheda is not there. So this is not going to work, I think. I think we bypassed all of these. all of these, because this last one, the only thing we can have is some chance is Vipratishuddham. It's not Vipratishuddham, so we cannot use. Okay, so let's go to the next one. So think about this next week and see if we can come back. And oh, this one is easy now. Shokascha Anandascha. Shokascha Anandascha. First of all, Shoka. Shoka is only two letters. You also have two rules coming over here, which you have to look at the Parakaryam, because we had two rules, which is the Ajajadantam, 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 Ajajadantam. Ajajadantam will favor the Ananda. It's Ajadi Adantam, but then Alpashtaram, which is the Shokaha. So Shokaha is Alpashtaram, so it is going to roll. That's your first starting point. So we can use that. And now we can use the Sutram, which talks about the opposite states, right? So it is Vipratishuddham. So Vipratishuddham Chalnadhikarana Vachi Viruddharthanam Adravya Vachinam Dandva Ekavad Vasyat Vasyat Shitoshnam Shitoshne. So look at what Vaikalpikaha Samaha Dvandvaha Chartiri Sutrana Praptaha. Again, he confirms that Vaikalpikaha Samaha Dvandvaha Chartiri Dvandvaha Sutrana Praptaha Eva. So this is also confirmed that this is you don't have to Vikalpa, you don't have to show. But Saha Viruddharthanam Yadi, if it's of Viruddharthanam Bhavati, Tarhi Adravya Vachinam Eva with Niyamartham. Another Niyamartham. If you have a viruddharthanam, and it will be vikalpaha only if it is anadhikaranavachi. Adhikaranavachi, if you have, it will only go to the itratra yogaha, because we talked about that shitoshne udakestaha, this hot and cold water. So now there we have to use only, to go back to only the itratra yogaha. But here we don't have that. We have Shokascha Anandascha. I think we can happily do Shokanandam. I think Shokanandam, choice. Shokanandam, Shokanandav. But this is Vikalpaha. This one is the Sutram, which is Pratishuddham Chalandhikaranavachi. Chalandhikaranavachi is the Viruddharthanam Adravyavachinam Ekavad Vasyat. So we'll use 2413. 2413. You have to make sure it's Adravyavachi. I think we have. So we'll use 2413 and make it Shokascha Anandascha. So the five, of course, skipping all the obvious steps, Shoka, Shokanandam, and also Shokanandau. Remember one thing, Shokanandau is 2229, and then we'll also be using 2413. And also be using before that Alpashtaram, Alpashtaram, and then in the end, one more thing to remind you is that the Lingam, Paravallingam, Dvandvatatpurushayoho, Paravallingam, Dvandvatatpurushayoho. Of course, here Shoka, Ananda are both masculine, but remember the Lingam is always Paravallingam, unless it's Samahara, Sanapumsakam is Samahara, otherwise Paravallingam. I think it's 2427, is it, 29? Paravallingam Dvandvatatpurushayoho, Paravallingam, no, it's 26, sorry, 26. Paravallingam Dvandvatatpurushayoho. So this one is that sutram we finally use here. Vipratishuddham Chalnadhikaranavachi. Okay, because Shokanandam Shokanandau, Alpashtaram. Okay, next one. Let's see what next one brings for us. Agnishcharandhanancha. Okay. First of all, Agni is going to go first. Alpashtaram is there. Agni also has the Ghisanya. So Agni is going to go first. Okay. Now go back to again our drawing board. See, can we use anything here? Agnishcharandhanancha. There's nothing to oppose these. There's no virodha over here. It's not a devata. There's nothing. Let's go down this quickly again. Can we use any of these things? Jatira Praninam. Again, remember, Jatir has to be Dravyavachi. Randhanam is Randhanam, I think, is like frying. Randhanam. So I don't think we can use this one. We cannot use any of these terms. If you don't check Randhanam for a second, Randhanam. Agnish Randhanancha. I think it is frying, baking Randhanam. अग्निश्च रंधनंच 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 निशरंधनंच रंधनम रंधे ओ इंजोरिंग आई एम सॉरी कुकिंग कुकिंग ओके कुकिंग फाइन सो फायर एंड कुकिंग फायर एंड कुकिंग I don't see anything that will force one way or the other. I'm don't because okay, let's go through it. Let's just practice because you know we only record these classes once. This is the last class. I think that you enjoy this fun of having this prakaranam of niyamartham. Okay, let's start from the top again as usual. This is not a you know senanga. You know nothing of that is coming. Prani tule senanga ram. We skip the next three. Jatihi is not cooking. Is not coming. Dravyavachi is not coming. It's not Agni is also not Jati, so it's in the fire. Then the Nadi Desha, we cannot use that. Then Jantavaha, you know, we cannot use that. Kshudra Jantavaha, Kshudra Jantavaha cannot use that. And then Virodha Shashvatikaha, no, this is fire and cooking. No, Virodha is not there. Shudranam, no. Gavasha Prabhudhinich, I don't think it's there in this. We'll check that. But then Vriksha Mruga Trunadhanya Vanjana. No, Pashu, Shakuni, Ashravadava, no, it's not there either. And then only thing is Vipratishiddham is also not there. Dasipayadini, only thing left to check now, two Ganas. So Gavasha Prabhudhini, that one, 2411 and 24. If it's not here, it should go in both. You know, this is the Agni Randhanam, let's just check. Gavasham, Kumcha Putra, Shri Dasi, शोणितं दर्भजना तृणोफलं दासी दासं गवाश दैट्स इट इज नॉट हियर 2414 बाय एनी चांस इफ इट इज देयर 2414 आल्सो इट्स प्रोबब्ली नॉट देयर दधिपयादि दधिपयसि नो 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 सो अग्निश्चरंधनं च आई थिंक वी ओनली हैव टू यूज द चार्थे द्वंद्वः एंड मेक इट यू नो विभाषयकवद् Of course, Agni will go first. Alpashtaram, also Dvandveghi. So we're going to get Agni, Randhane, and Agni, because this is from a Paravallingam. Randhanam is neuter. So Paravallingam. Agni Randhane, Agni Randhanam. Agni Randhanam. Agni Randhanam. So we have used Chathya Dvandvaha. And then we have used the Dvandveghi, Alpashtaram is more important, Alpashtaram, they use that, Paravallingam has been used, Paravallingam, and I think that's it. Vibhasha Ekavat, Agnirandhane, Agnirandhanam, Agnirandhane, Agnirandhanam, Alpashtaram, Dvandveghi, and the Paravallingam, Vunatatpurushayoho, and Vibhasha Ekavat, I don't think we can use anything from 2-4. But think about it. If next week you feel something we missed, please, we can also talk about that. Next one now. Next one, what we have is the Agnischa Varunascha. Agnischa Varunascha. Of course, we're going to use the sutram which is going to come for the Devata Dvandvecha. Devata Dvandve, when we have, we talk about Devata. In fact, the example from Kamudi itself, which is coming down here, is the Devata Dvandvecha. So it becomes. And then Idagnehe, Somvarunayoho, Devata Dvandva Ityeva, becomes Agni Varunau. Agni, for sure, Agni will go first, Alpashtaram, it has, also has the Ghisanya, so Agni will go first. But now let's come to the more interesting thing, can we make Samahara here or no? Can you make samahara between these two now, Agni and Varuna? I think we probably can, because look at this sutram which I mentioned to you before, that this sutram here itself, I think we can clinch the issue here. Because here, when Panini talks about the Dhipayadini, he Brahma Prajapati Panini gives over here. Brahma Prajapati, he says, do only itaritara yoga. The fact that Panini has to give Brahma Prajapati in the Gana, if it were not here, it should take Samahara also. Same thing over here. Shiva Vaishravanau. So Shiva Vaishravanau, say Shiva and Kubera, also Devatas. So this should also not be in this Gana. If there's no Samaharasya Prapti Redi Nasti, Tarhi Ganepahataha, so it will be Anarthakaha. syat. It'll be completely useless to put Shiva Vaishrava now in this gana, Brahma Prajapati in this gana, if there's no need to put in here, if they're already going to be only Itaritara Yogaha. So this, in fact, pretty much confirms for us that we can make Agni, Agni Varunam and Agni Varunau. We can make Agnischa Varunascha, Agni Varunau, Agnischa Varunascha, Anayoho Samaharaha, Agni Varunam is what I'm thinking. Because that 2, 4, 14 pretty much does it for us. Because we can go through the remaining, I mean, it's nothing, you all went through many times. It's not a Senanga or Pranyanga or the Turyanga. You know, it is not a Jatihi. Agni, there's two specific devatas, Agni and Varuna. That's not, it's not the Naridesha is not there. It's not the Jantavaha, Shudra Jantavaha. It's not there. Then I don't think it's in this Gana. We can check if you want. And then Ruksham Rigatranadhani is not in this list. Vipatishadham is not there. Only thing remaining is to, by chance, you can check this Gana 2, 4, 11, unless it is here by any chance. Then, of course, you have to go with that, what's there. Where it says, Gavashram, no. Okay. So then we have to make it Agni. Of course, we have to use the Idagne has to be used. Idagne, I think 6329, is it? Idagnehe samavaranayoho varanayoho. So 6327 has to be used. We have to do that. But otherwise we can make it Agni Varanau Agni. So I think we can use all the same rules as before and make it Agni Varanau and also make it Agni Varu. Nam. So we can use all these rules, Chathe Dvandvaha, Dvandvegi, Alpashtaram, Paravallingam, and of course we have to use here the Idagnehe Sumavaranayoho. So we have to use 6327. This is important. So same otherwise. Alright, so that's we got that one. We got this one here. The same thing with the next two examples, I think. Same thing next example. Next example here is the Agnischa Vayuscha. How about these two now? Same argument. I don't think we can force the Itaritara Yoga here. And here is that this is the Vartikam which we saw about the Devata Dvandve. This in that there is a Vartikam over here which says Vayu specifically. When you take Vayu, It doesn't allow that operation. So it says tapotaro anang agniva. So vayu shabda yoga patishedha agnivayu vayavagni. In fact, he always gives you. Look at this agnivayu vayavagni. Now the both agni and vayu have the ghi sanya, dvandve ghi. Alpashtaram will not help you because agni and vayu both two ach they have. And then also Lagvaksharam also will not help you because Vayu is Dirga, but Agni has a Sanyoga Guru. So and for here everything, so because we can check all of these things now. So Lagvaksharam will not, I mean the Alpashtaram will not help you. Lagvaksharam will not help you. Dvandve Givna, they have both give Ghi Sanya. And Ajadi Adantam. It's not Adantam. Agni is Ajadi, not Adantam, but so and for nothing will tell you Niyamaha. Niyamaha Kartum na Shakyate. Make a niyamaha. So Agni Vayu Vayavagni. And then we can even make the samara out of it. Agni Vayu. Then Vayavagni. So it become, I think we can have four forms, I think, over here, which is the Agnischa Vayuscha. We can make Anayoho Samaraha Atava Pakshe Itritra Yogaha. Become Agni Vayu Vayavagni and it will become Agni Vayu and Vayavagni because in the it will decline like you know Madhu or like the Vari when you put in the neuter because Napumsakam it will be Ekavat and Napumsakam. So I'm going to put these four forms here. Let me know if you agree or don't agree about this. So So I don't see any Niyamaha in the same logic. Brahma Prajapati has to be forced to make into Itaratra Yoga. That means that these can go either way. So we'll make it Agni. Sorry. So you can make it Agni Vayu, and we can make Vayavagni. Vayavagni. And I think we can also make it like that. We can make it Agni Vayu. Agni Vayu. And also make it Vayavagni. I know there's a typo here. 1 second. Vayavagni. So the second will be Samahara. And this will be Tritaya. So make Vayavagni. Okay. So Agni Vayu, Vayavagni. And Agni Vayu, Vayavagni. So it can both ways. Now here we have used only 229 charches. Dvandvaha. We cannot make any Niyama for this. And then we use the Vartikam. Vartikam, which is the on 6026 Vayu Shabda Prayoge Patishedaha Anang Nabhavati. No Anang. So Vartikam on 6323 Vartikam. So 6323 Vartikam. 23 Vartikam, which is this one. Vayu Shabda Prayoge Patishedaha. Okay, that is my thinking on that one. Again, these are all, you know, my thinking. So if you feel something different, let me know. This is the Vartikam there. Okay, next one. Let's see what next one brings for us. Next one is saying, the Vrishtischa Vayushcha. How about these now? Vrishtischa Vayushcha. First of all, Vrishti and Vayu, this is not Devata now. I don't think Vrishti is a Devata. There's no question of Anang. Even if Anang was there, Vayu will not take Anang anyway. Now, how about the Nipataha? So Vrishti and Vayu. Alpashtaram will not help. Lagvaksharam also won't help. Even though Vayu Dirgha, this one is Sanyoge Guru, is also gone. Then how about the Ghisanya? They both have. Vrishti has it, Ikaranta. Vayu has it, Ukaranta. Ajajantam, no, they're not there. So I think we can go both ways. Okay, how about the Samahara versus the Dvandvaha? It's not a Jati, not a Prani, Tulya Sena, it's not Vriksha Mruga, it's not there. I think we are down to the usual. This is not, Vrishti and Vayu also not, I don't think there's any, Pripati Shedha is not there. So Viruddhartanam, I don't think we can use these two. The Vipadishiddham, I don't think we can use that. This Anadhikarana Vachi anyway, so we can't do that. So other one is Yesham Virodha Shashvatikaha. We can't use that. So Varsha and, I mean, Vrishti and Vayu, no. So then I think we are back to the usual suspects, which is these two Ganas, which is Gavasha Prabhuti Nicha. And unless it's somewhere here, which I don't think it is. And then other one is the Dhatipaya Adini, which is the other one. So there also it may not be there. Dhatipaya Adini. Okay, so it is not there. Okay, so I think we can go both ways here. So we can make it similar to what we had here, this same thing. So we will have the Vrishti Vayu, so we can first start, because we'll have four forms. We'll have Vrishti Vayu, then we can also have Vayu Vrishti, then we'll get the same thing, Vrishti Vayu, and so we can take the same one here, make it Samahare, Vrishti Vayu. Vayu, and also make it Vayu Rishti. Yeah. I must say I have not seen any book really, you know, which goes in such detail and goes through all these sutras and gives us all these multiple forms, you know. In the Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi, we have only one sutram, which is that, you know, the Prani, Tulya Senanga, and only one sutram is there. So you know, even though I'm giving all these answers, I'm not able to confirm these answers from any, you know, authoritative source as such. I mean, I'm giving you what all I have and logic which I think should work. But like, for example, this one, is this absolutely correct? It looks correct, but, you know, it is. I'm not able to confirm from any book which clearly goes and gives all the answers like that, you know. Not able to get that. But it seems to me, first of all, I think this part is quite clear. Vrishti and Vayu both have the Ghee Sanya. And you cannot use the Lagvaksharam, Alpashtaram. Nothing is really there. And then this is fine. Can we use Samhara also? Looks to be fine to me. It's not a Jati. It's not anything like that. I don't think we can, there's nothing to stop it. But can I confirm this from any book? I'm not able to do that. I'm not able to find a good book which will, you know, confirm all these forms for us like that. Okay. Next one is coming to be the Ganga. This one is easy now. Ganga is given directly, is given in the sutra. Ganga cha yamuna cha. Ganga yamune. Ganga yamune. This is straightforward example. Directly from the Kaumudi, I think. So this one is here, which is the Nadi Desha. It is Vishishta Lingaha. Nadidesho Gramaha. So Gramavarja Nadidesha Vachinam Vinna Linganam Samahare Dvandvaha Ekavasyat. But he says that Bingalinganatikim Ganga Yamune. So right, Ganga Yamune. So Bingalinganam itikim Ganga Yamune. So if it's the same gender, of course Ganga goes first because it is, you know, Alpashtaram, maybe Abhyashatam also possibly, and then Ganga Yamune, which is the same lingam, they will not go in Samaj with Ganga Yamune. Ganga Yamune. So this is the Niyama is going both ways again. Vishishtalinga Nadi, it'll go, you know, Samaj. If it's not, it'll go only the other way. Ganga Yamune. Ganga Yamune, it'll go. So here, yeah, so this is going to be, I'll take just copy it from the Kaumudi. So this is 247. You take from 247, and Bindalinganam Kim Ganga Yamune. It pretty much tells the whole thing, you know. Ganga Yamune. Ganga Yamune. Okay. Linganam Kim Ganga Yamune. So Ganga cha Yamuna cha Ganga Yamune. Of course, Paravallingam, Antat Purusha Yoho, you have to make it feminine. So it's like Divachanam Ganga Yamune, Nalingana Kim. So, the usual set of rules, I think there is special 2429 will come, I mean, sorry, 2229, I'm sorry, 2229, 247, Paravallingam also you can bring in, and otherwise the usual rules. Yes, Anuji has a question. Yes, let me see. But, yes, Anuji.
Satyaji, even though you put 247, that won't apply for this particular exercise, right? Because it is both are feminine.
Yes, but thing is that, Anuji, if you did not have 247, you could have Vibhasha Ekavad, right? So if 247 were not to be there, you could do both ways, couldn't you?
Oh, that way.
Yeah, so this is very complicated because it's okay. Almost niyama, it's the reverse niyama doing done now. So 247 is saying that if it is, you know, vingalinganam samahara eva. If it is not, you have to go to itarata yoga, it seems. Because see, Kaumudi gives the example, he only gives one. He gives Ganga Yamune only. Doesn't give Ganga, Yamunam. He doesn't give that. So that is not a choice. I don't think that Samar is a choice here, Anuji. I don't think it is. So if 247...
No, it's not.
Yes. But I think if 247...
It's not, so that's why I was... Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's not right, there, then it would go both ways.
Yeah, that's the thing. If this
yeah,
was,
okay, all right.
That's what I'm saying. That Vibhasha is always Prapta. Prapta
Vibhasha.
We have to stop Vibhasha by some... You have to stop Vibhasha by some means, right? So the vivash has to be stopped by some. That's the whole trick in this whole exercise, is that the vivash has to be stopped by some sutra. Otherwise, it's going to be Vibhasha everywhere. And the only way
that's
to stop
the principle.
It, so that's because that's in the beginning itself was said. Beginning itself, we mentioned that many times.
Sorry.
That this Niyamartham Sutram, Prakaranam. So we have to, so if you're saying we don't need 247, then how will you stop the Vibhasha from where?
Correct. Yeah, okay.
That is the argument. That is the argument. Yeah, I know it's very confusing, this one. Very confusing. So 247, we need 247, I think. Stop the Vibhasha. So, okay. Now, the next one is the Patrani cha Pushpani cha. Patrani cha Pushpani cha. What can we use here? Patrani cha Pushpani cha. Let's bring Anuji since he was participating. What do you think here, Anuji? Patrani cha Pushpani cha. What do you think of this one?
246.
Yes. Good fit here. This is that the Jatira Pranina. That should be fit just fine because Patra and Pushpa is generic, right? It's a leaf.
Yeah, right.
And but before we go there, which one will go first, Patra or Pushpa? What do you think is the choice? Any choice?
Well,
Alpashtaram. No, Patra Pushpa both have two acha. Lagvaksharam also no use, right? Because Patra, mm-hmm. Pushpa both have Sanyoga following. There is no Ajadi, there is no Ji Sanya, so that's also gone. I think we can go both ways, can't we?
Yep.
Patra Pushpam, Pushpa Patram, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Jatira, I think we can Jatira Praninam. One more thing, one more complication here, by the way, is that it's not a prani. Is it a living thing or not? this is the pain of Vyakaranam. Now you take it. Because if some people can claim that this is somehow, you know, in fact, you can even go one more, is it prani angam or not? Prani anganam, that's also there. I think the answer is no. The answer is no. Because we talk about this, you know, a praninam. I think I read this in one of Jatira Praninam. And it says, I think here they talk like, you know, jati means has to be the prani, has to be like manushya, etc. prani. So, not like, you know, thing like, you know, branches. They are not pranis, you know. They don't count. Let me see if I can find quickly for you. Jatira Praninam. Jatira Praninam, a Praninam, so, okay, he gives that. So somewhere I read this thing that Dravya Jati, okay, that's, I found that. Jati Hikim, Sanya Shabdo Vetao. If I say Jati Hikim, Nandaka Pancha Janyo, Sanya Shabdo Vetao. That's what Vasu was saying. These are proper nouns. Nandaka Pancha Janyo. We talked about that. Jati Pradhanyapi Bahuvachanam Jate Jati. Okay, I'm not able to find it now, but I think, let me see, maybe it was Nagesha which said something over here, that this is not to be taken as, you know, Jatira Pranina, Jatira Pranina, Jati, he said that, Atra Prani Shabdena, Loka Prasiddhaha, Manushyadayaha, Eva Grijyante, Natu Vrikshadayaha, Iti Bhashye Sitam. So this is only when you say a prani nam in this sutram jatra prani nam. You don't take trees and things like this in this prani. They don't call the prani over here. Only mean loka prasiddhaha manushyadayaha eva griyante natu vrikshadayaha iti. So I think we can, a prani will not apply to patra and pushyam on that. Otherwise I think we are okay because this is going to be the, it's a jati. It's a generic term. It's not prani. And I think we are, and it's dravyavachi. Dravya Jati Naam, so I think we're going to be fine. I think you can go both ways. You can go Patra Pushpam and Pushpa Patram. Now, but don't forget our other one, which is that you're talking about one particular leaf and one particular flower. Then you have to go back to Tisra Yoga. Because, you know, that is the final straw to this is, because when we went, this one it says that Dharva Vishesha Vivakshayam to Badara Malakani. It will go back to being one. So if you talking about you know, one specific leaf, one specific flower, then you cannot use the. It's not a genus. It's not about a class of items. It's talking about one leaf and one particular flower, not a class of leaf flower. That is the thing. Keep in mind.
Like Graham and Udyanam, right?
Yes. So you're going to have. So Jati of Pranam has this one condition. It has to be that, you know, Samanya Jati, not the Dravya Vishesha Vakshaya. So it requires a lot of thinking. Now, let's not forget this Vartikam down here. Let's see if that applies. This Phala, Sena, Vanaspati, Mruga, Shakuni, Kshudrajantu, Dhanyatrananam, Bahu Prakriti Reva. I think that we don't have to, because we are talking about, you know, this one. No, it's talking about many fruits and things like that. I don't think we have to use that. Many, you know, many berries, many this. In fact, we have that also here. Right now we have. The example itself has Bahu Prakriti. That we are okay anyway. Putra patayanta pushpani cha he gives. So, okay. So what we'll do is that we will take that one from here. I think we will take it this one. So, we'll take this one and then put it down here. Okay. So we'll take patrani cha pushpani cha. But of course here they're going to go both ways. So patrani cha pushpani cha, and so we're going to get two forms. So we will not get these. We'll have to use the jati. We'll use that. We'll get the patra pushpani. We'll get pushpa patrani. We'll get two forms here. So we'll get this one here. So patra pushpani. And then we'll also get, because there's no way to make Niyamaha in this, we'll get Pushpa Patrani. So Pushpa Patrani. We'll get this one here also. Patrani. Use this one. And then on top of that, Dravya Vishesha Vivakshayam too, we'll get the, I'm sorry, this should have been here, I'm sorry. So this one will be the, when you talk about specific, you know, fruits, specific leaves and specific flowers. Some few leaves, few flowers, not the class. Then we get this one. And here we'll get patra pushpam and pushpa patram. Okay, I think finally we got it. Alright, so one more time. Patranicha pushpanicha is a jati aparani. Vikam patra pushpam pushpa patram. Unless you're talking about some specific leaves and flowers, patra pushpani. Pushpatrani. Okay, so I think time is getting up, but okay, let me see. We have a couple of minutes. We can do one more, maybe. Akshini Chabruho. This is straightforward. So this is the Pranyanga, and it's specifically given in 5477. So we don't have to even think about this. In fact, the next three, we don't have to, because Akshini Chabruho cha, Vak cha, Manas cha. We can next do these two. Let's just do these two. We can stop with that. Okay, let's do these two. Akshinicha Bhruvavacha is clearly going to be the Pranyanga. So there's no question about going anywhere. So straightforward, he says Pranyanga. So this is going to be only Samaharaha. And we have already seen that we saw the Samasanta Achprateha. We've seen in this long sutram, which is 5477. We already saw 5477. But Panini gives the form directly, he gives Akshibhruvam. Akshibhruvam is straightforward, given to us. It's only one form, Akshibhruvam. There's no other form. And we saw this in a prior lesson. Akshibhruvam 5477. We have to use 2229, but then just use 5477. Akshibhruvam. Here it is. Akshibhruvam. So that Akshibhruvam. So Akshibhru, and then normally you would have had only Raswa at the end, Akshibhru. So you get the Achpratyaya, you get the Uvanga Desha. You get Akshibhruvam. same thing, the Vang Manas also we use in the Gana itself, Dhadipaya Adini, Dhadipaya Adini. So we have to use the Akshibhravam. This is a given form to us, so we can use, sorry, this is a, yeah, we use the Uvangadeshaha. Anyway, the form is given, Akshibhru is given in the Sutram itself, 5477. This Akshibhruvam. Now, Vangmanasi. Now, what is the last one for today? Okay, last one, promise, last one for today. What do you think, Anuji? What do we do here? It's in the Gana. Vangmanasi, first of all, that the in the Sutram itself, we have this form, which is the Vangmanase we have. So Vang Manas we already have here. Vang Manas we have. Vang Manasa we have. And then we also have this Dhadipaya Adini is Vang Manase. So only one form. Dhadipaya Adini. The question is that why did this have to be in this Gana? What's the reason of putting in this Gana? What would have happened if it's not in this Gana? That's the question. So if it were not in this Gana, what would have happened? We would have had either a samahara or a vikalpaha. But now which sutra would you use for that? What do you think, Anuji? Vang and Manas. What can we use?
Pranyanga? If it had not been in this, yes.
What?
That's what we would have. No. That we could have used, right?
Pranyanga nam is like hand, like this is mind and speed. Can we use Pranyanga? That's my question. Because Panipadam is straightforward, hands and legs. The fact that you should put in this Gana by Panini, if it were not in this Gana, either Samahara was Praptaha or it could have been into a Vikalpa. Let me quickly check. I know time is out for us. Because Pranyanga is tempting to use here. Because it is mind and speech, it belongs to a living being, right? I think we can...
But it looks like they are subtle parts.
Yeah, they are not Dravyavachi. It's the only question, they are not Dravyavachi. We are not talking about, you know, a physical thing. But this...
Gross.
Yes. Let me see. Brahma Prajapati, there is... yeah, okay. Well, we'll think about it. We'll go with that for now. Anyway, Vang Manase is given as there's only one form. It's not about that. The form is only one. Vang Manase.
Only one.
Yeah, that's clear.
So Satishi, this could be that by default you have two forms, and this is forcing you to have only Itaritarandra.
Is that the case, or is it that we'll have only Samahara by Pranyanga? That's my question.
Actually, 242 Kashika gives you a very good synopsis.
Okay, let's see what it is.
Kashika 242.
Okay, let's see 242. Okay. 242. Let's see what Kashika is saying. Angasham pratyekam, we got that. So Pranyanganam, Dandva, that's fine. Turyanganam. He gives, but Panipadam Shirogrivam, you know, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Yeah, they always give the easy ones.
Yeah, so here you look at this. Itaretare yoga samahare cha dvandvaha vihitaha.
Itra
samaharasya ekatva siddham eva ekvachanam.
Jamtu
prakaranam vishaya vibhagartham.
Yeah, correct.
Pani angadi nam samahara eva.
Dvandvaha.
Dvandvaha. Nam itaretare yoga eva.
Vriksham ruga uvyata. I know all that. Everything I know. But the question is that, you know, can we include the Vang and Manas like Pani, Padam and Shiro Grivam?
I think anyway, you can include it, right? Because you can say Manas is also part of the Pani Anga, right?
No, Prani is fine, but Anga, is it Anga? That's the only question. Prani, we got it.
You can say it is Anga, right?
Antaranga. So, that is, yeah, it's Antakaranam, you see. So, I mean, in a way, because Manas Antakaranam. So, anyway, what I'm saying is the answer will not change. Regardless, is only one, because this answer is the same. Vang Manas is only one form. The only thing we're arguing about is that this Gana, is it put here because to avoid the Vibhasha? Or is it avoid the Pranyanga? The Nitya Samahara. That's it. Anyway, just time is up, so let's continue with this next week. I think enough. enough of, you know, jumping up for today. So we will, yes, it's taking time, but, you know, as I said, I'm not finding any, you know, any real way to get more confirmation on these things. So, but 2.4.14 gives us only one form here, which is the Wang Manase. The only question is that would this have counted as a Pranayangam or not? So the only question is that would 2.4.2 have otherwise applied? That's the only question here, applied. Or is this to stop the Vibhasha only, that's what Kalpesh is saying. So this is, is this to avoid the Vibhasha, or is it to avoid the 2.4.2 that Panipur Swam? Of course, you have to put the 6.5.4.77 because put the Achpratya at the end. So anyway, answer is Wang Manase. It is given form in 5.4.77 and 2.4.14. The only question remains is that would there have been Nityam Samahara? Or would there have been a Vibhasha had we not had it in the Dadipaya Adi? Let's stop with that. Continue next time. Ramo Rajamani Sada Vijayate Ramam Ramesham Bhaje Ramena Vyata Nishachara Chamu Ramaya Tasmai Namaha Raman Nasti Parayanam Parataram Ramaschada Sosmiyaham Rame Chittale Sada Bhautame Bho Rama Mamudhara राम रामेति रामेति रमे रामे मनोरमे सहस्रनाम तत्तुल्यं राम नाम वरानने श्री राम नाम वरानन ओन्नमेति. So next time's homework, I have to complete these last three. I think last two are quite straightforward anyway. And then this one is going to be easy now, because this is already, we don't have to worry, because these are already given forms to us. So we can talk about this thing, but, you know, we don't have to break our heads so much. Only when you're composing, you have to think about it. And when you're only given the form to you, then it's already accepted, no? So, oh, by the way, give me 1 second, I'm sorry. I'm seeing something here, 5.4.106. I'm sorry, I know time is up, but did I miss something here? 5.4.106. Okay. You missed 1 point. No stop the recording yet. You missed 1 point. Is there, look at the samahare dvandva chudashah antat. We should be checking this. We didn't check this. Okay. Let me go back. I'll repeat next class again. But this 5.4.106 should have been applied here. I'm sorry. We missed this 1 point. So I'll confirm next time again. When we did apachya vipachya, we should have make it vipadapade. Samaharaha. Samahara should take the dvandva chu da sha ha anta samahare. So samahare is 5.4.106. I'm sorry, time is up. But let's look at 5.4.106 quickly, and we'll do it next time again. So 5.4.106 says that, which is dakaranta, right? Chavarga dakaranta. So here we get the samidrishadam should be vipadapadam, sampadvipadam, here it is, sampadvipadam, should be vipadapadam, not this one. Okay, remind me next time, I'll start with this next class. You made a mistake today, we were so engrossed in the other ones, we didn't think about this one. So 5.4.106 applies here.
Will that apply for both the forms?
Only Samahare.
Samahare, okay. Okay.
So we didn't miss that.
Yes,
one.
Yes.
We missed this part. So next time we start the class with this one. Vipadapadam, we have the Chu Da Sha Khanta Samahare. So 5.4.106 we start next time. Okay. One more time. Ramo Rajamani Sada Vijayate Ramam Ramesham Vijay. रामेणाभियत निशाचर चमो रामाय तस्मै नमः रामान् नास्ति परायणं परतरं रामश्चदासोऽस्म्यहं रामे चित्तले सदा भवतु मे भो राम मां धर राम रामेति रामेति रमे रामे मनोरमे सहस्रनाम तत्तुल्यं राम नाम वरानने श्रीराम नाम वरानन ओके वस्वीर ओके.